It's really good to be here. Vivian, thank you so much. Please clap for Dr. Vivian. Thanks for putting this together. It's really an honor to be speaking at the Parents Summit Africa. Africa speaks of the continent of a global reach, and this is going places in Jesus' name. When I saw my name on the program, I said, Vivian, I thought you liked me. Why would you allow these fabulous people to speak before me? What do you want me to say again? Please clap for all the wonderful speakers in the house. It's really, really an honor and a pleasure to be here. And I love the topic that Vivian gave me because as a mother of four, and from my profile, you see I'm a very busy mom. Like most of us are, we're all very busy parents. You know, to even take out time, all the hours you've been here, it took some planning, it took some intentionality. So we're all really busy people. So how do you be present with all the books you're writing? I have a full-time job, I'm coaching, I'm mothering, I have a 17-year-old who's off to university tomorrow. I have a 16-year-old who's writing SAT soon and, you know, always in my room and asking me, well, what do I do now? I have a 13-year-old daughter who is at that stage of life where she's, you know how teenagers are, teenage girls, you know? And then I have a 7-year-old who still thinks he's a baby and just wants to be with mommy. He was meant to be with me here today, but his cousin came over. So, and then I have a husband. So everybody needs attention, you know, and I have an active social life as well. I'm busy in church, I go for parties. If I'm from here, I have a party, 20 minutes, you know, I'll pop in and go off. So how do we make it work? How are you there for your children and for those who matter the most? How do you give them the best of you so that you can have time to be yourself, to be whole, and impact them the way they should be? Because the truth is that they are the most important people. Not the job, not the books, not any other thing you're doing. They, your family, your children, they are the ones that have been given to you by God to pour into for some years. And once they go to university, the truth is that at that stage they are, you know, already going out. Once they enter boarding school, to be honest, how often are you seeing them anymore? Holidays, visiting days, and that's it. So how can you be present? How can you truly be there? How can you be there for what matters and let them feel your impact? The first way to be present really is your time. Zig Ziglar says that the way a child spells love is T-I-M-E. Let's say it together. T-I-M-E. Time. Time. So while, you know, some people will say, oh, it's really about quality time, the quantity, it's not true. Quality time is important, but the quantity is important. Because how much quality can it have if it's hardly there? If there's no quantity to it, to it in the first place. So you must spend time with these children. You must have time for them. You must say, look, this is what I'm going to do today, and this is how I'm going to do it. Because nothing can replace the time you spend with these children. That's the honest truth. Ask your child anything. You know, sometimes I pick up my younger one from school and he'll say, Mommy, are you going back to the office? Because if you're going back, please next time don't pick me. Because he wants me to stay with him from to the end of the day. You know, that's what he wants. Because there's nothing more important than seeing Mommy or Daddy with them at that age. They really want to be around you. So your time is important. The quality of it and the quantity of it. But there's so many things that affect this time that we have. Distractions. Things that, you know, juggle for these 24 hours that we have. And one of them is this. Our mobile phones, our gadgets. For many of us, Auntie Chichi, good to see you. For many of us, this is like our office, how we catch all, you know, all the gossip. You know, for those of us that create content, how we create content. It's our camera, how we take pictures. We do so much on these gadgets. And it's easy for time to just go as you're flipping. You see one thing and you forget what you went there to see. I start looking at all that, this dress is nice. What's happening? And that's it. And then, you know, you're on your phone and time just goes by. So you need to be intentional about how much time you spend on these gadgets. They're there to help you make your life easier. They're not there to be an impediment. And to be, they can't take away the time that is meant for your family and meant for you. So you need to use them wisely. You should use them, they should not use you. There are a lot of apps you can use, to help us when we're on Instagram, so that when your time for Instagram is up, you know, and you can put your phone down. So gadgets, TV, Big Brother, so many things take up our time, and we need to say, look, I hardly watch TV, that's the honest truth, because with all the time I have, I said, okay, what's most important to me now? I'm on that list, TV comes way down. So I do watch a good series now and then, but I don't have that much time. So I am very intentional about the things I give my time, my essence to, because time can never be gotten back. Once it's gone, it's gone. Even with friends, who do I spend time with? What are we talking about? Because that time you spend gisting with that person who is adding absolutely nothing to your life can never be gotten back. You can spend that time at home, just staring at your baby. I tell you, that child will get more value, even if they can't talk, by just having their mother or their father close to them. And then, like I said, social life. Today, I was meant to be at a prayer meeting. I had this event. I have a birthday party. I have a service of songs. I have another meeting. 5. What do? You choose. You can't be at every, you can't be everywhere at every time. It's not possible. Sometimes we overrate our importance. Which of the events do you need to be at? Which one will, if you're not there, will they say, where's Ronke? What happened? She has a role to play here. Or you go there, you'll be the first person there before the event has started. If it's wedding, you'll be there, and you will stay. To everyone. I think they're packing plates, you're still there. I don't understand. The other day, someone called me. I said, I should come and escort her to somebody's child's wedding. I'm one big man. I said, I will dress up, make up, and then come back. I must say, you can escort your friends and hang out with them and spend time. Don't get me wrong. But you have to be very, very intentional about what you spend your time on. Prioritize. That prayer meeting, I could have gone this morning. It's a good meeting. But I knew I was going to be here today, and I knew I had something else to do. So I said, no, there'll be another meeting next week and the week after. It's okay. Yes, the because I would have liked to see me, I know. I'll make it up to her. But time with my family, that time I spent with them this morning, priceless. Priceless, you know. So we need to know what is important. Major on the major. Remove those things that are impediments, and then have a cook, you know, a burner. What are the things that need to be on the front burner that need your attention constantly? What are the things that you can put at the back and let them just be steaming for like 24 hours? Everything doesn't have need the same amount of time. So remove the distractions that are limiting the time you spend with these children so you can truly be present with them. And then let's go back to the quality. Yes, we've said it has to have quantity, and it must have quality. Certainly it must have quality. Somebody was speaking, I think it was Hajja Halima that was saying how her father was so pressured that she couldn't wait to get out of the house. And obviously the time she spent with her father wasn't quality time. She didn't enjoy it. Or her mother shouting, that wasn't quality time. She didn't want it. And my son, my 17-year-old, said something one day. He said, Mommy, when I go, the bus, at times they drop us off. And there's some children, when they see their parents' cars outside, they're like, oh man, why is Mommy home? Why? And then there's some that they see their parents, they're like, oh, Mommy is home, Daddy is back. And he said, you will never understand the first group. How can you be unhappy that your parents are back from work early? How? And I said, because the time they're spending at home with them is not good. It's not memorable. It doesn't have quality. It lacks essence. They are constantly being nagged out, being criticized, complaining at them, shouting at them, carrying all the stress of their whatever else they're dealing with, and pouring on this innocent child who didn't have to be born. So that's why. That's why. So the time you're spending with your children is quality time. What are you doing with them? For some children, yes, you take them out, but all you know how to do is to take them to eat. That's all. That's your only enjoyment with children. It's not bad, though. It's good. But that's all. There's no variety. Someone told me that her child said, Mommy, I'm tired of going for pizza. That's all you do. I'm tired. The girl, she was tired. That's your only outing. Ah, let's go out, children. Pizza time. So at the point, she said, oh, Mommy, it's okay. I have homework. But she's tired. So she was telling me that you need to be more creative and think of things to do. And we need to think of things to make that time more enjoyable. The time spent with you must be time that they look forward to. So that when Daddy is coming home, they are rushing to the door, not running away to say, Daddy is back, wahala. The time they spend with you must be time that they're like, oh, every minute they're holding on to it. you shouldn't be distracted in that time, which is why I speak to you about that phone issue. Sometimes your children are with you, you're on the phone. I'm guilty because at times I'm like, oh, I'm creating content. Hold on, it's like, mommy, I'm talking. And there's time for work, there's time for your child. There's time to focus on them and say, okay, you know what? This isn't that important. Call me at 9 o'clock. We'll create that content later. This is time for my children. When they've gone to bed, I can do what I need to do. So you have to be creative in creating that time. Because you always hear people say, ah, I'm making time. I always wonder, what does that mean? How can you make time? But you can be creative about making more time for your children. When you're saying, I want it to be time that has quality. Maybe you have to wake up a bit earlier. Maybe you have to do school runs once in a while, even though it's difficult for you. Maybe you have to go for walks with them. Do things that will make them know that mom is human. A lot of us, our parents don't know we're ever young. They think we grew up as in adults because of the way you are around them. You act like there's nothing wrong with you. You're perfect in every way. You've always been that. And they can't even relate with you, which makes it hard for them to even enjoy being around you. So have fun. Have conversations. Talk with them. Talk to them. Don't just talk at them. Don't let every time with your child be a time for, ah, how are your studies? Okay, very good. Okay, go and do your homework. That's it. No relationship, nothing beyond that. All I want you to do is confess. We paid plenty school fees. That's all. That's all you want to know. What happened to asking about their friends and knowing who their friends are? What happened to, you know, discussing maybe the crush that they have and telling them, look, it happened to me as well, but you know there's time for everything. What happened to telling them about how your day at work was? So they can know that you too, you have, you know, people annoy you and you know how to deal with that, you know how to tolerate people. What happened to just asking them, Speed Darlington, what do you think about that guy? To even know how they think of, you know, what's his opinion about all these things that are going on? Because it's important, so you can even correct errors, yes, inaccuracies, and just, you know, because they know anyway. Even if you say, oh, in my house, we don't watch Big Brother, they know everybody in the house. They know everybody. So you better talk to them. You better have real conversations with them. You better let them know what you stand for as a family and make sure these values are passed across clearly. And you can only do that through quality time. Have lunch together. Sometimes it's not easy because, you know, you close at a particular time, but maybe Sunday afternoons, Saturday mornings, make it something the children will look forward. Prayer time. With my children, I try and do morning and evening. You could do one or two, you know, twice a day. Those, even if it's 5 minutes, I promise you, that is presence. That has been there. During that time, you can ask them, how was your day? Share your testimony. That way, just, oh, this happened in the office today. You know, what do you have? You know, what are you grateful for? And just talk, just be playing with them, and they will open up and they will talk. So we need to spend quality time with them. And then if you're very busy and you have a lot of things to do, like me, sometimes if I have a radio interview, I take my children with me. Someone taught me that. And for them, it's a different experience, like an excursion of sorts, because they're learning about the radio, and you're there working. In my office, they all know my children, because I bring them to one, so they can understand this is what mommy does for a living. I'm spending time with them, they're seeing what I do. It's important. These are all times of spending, always spending quality time with your children. And I'm still talking about that quality time. What happens when they're in school? How can you be present when your child is in school? It's not too hard. Participate. My mom's friend told me once, if you love your child, the school will love your child. What she was trying to say was that if your child, I'm talking about the general school, especially the boarding houses of those days, if they see that you're that parent that will always come around, always ask questions, they won't mess with your child. They might say, this one, he always brings them no food. The truth is that people are very, they're very careful and mindful of certain things. If you're that parent that doesn't take, I'm not saying that one that goes to go and fight with the school, or no, not that kind of parents. But the parent that shows up, the parent that participates, the parent that is an asset to the school. Your child is the last child anybody would even dare do anything funny. So you need to show that you're present and you need to be part of the school community. In my children's school, I made sure they started a PTA in the secondary school. They didn't want to. They felt, oh, PTA, they will harass us. They will allow us to increase school fees. I said, no. We're here to partner with you to help out. We want to be part of our children's lives, even when they're in school. We know what you guys are doing, how you're acting in local parents, and we want to assist while they're in school. And they saw, look, this is a great idea, so that's why. They, you know, and they've seen that we've been assets. We in the PTA have been assets to those schools. So you must participate. If your child is in boarding house, you should must know the headmaster, you must know their friends, you must know everything. Even if your child is in Lagos and you're here, the school must know you. That's how to be present. So that even when you're not there, your child feels you. Because presence really is not just about being there, but it's about being felt. Because somebody can be in this room and you won't even feel that the person is there. The person lacks presence. The person is invisible. The person is there. But when you have presence, everybody knows you're there. As a parent, you must have presence. And that goes to this thing that we talk about, you know, developments. We all have big houses. Everybody is getting expanded. Your families are getting bigger by the grace of God. He's increasing you on every side. So you move from a one-bedroom to a two-bedroom to a duplex. And everybody's in the house, but nobody is together. Every child is on their own system. You're in your room on your phone or watching Big Brother or whatever you're doing. Daddy is, you know, doing his work, you know, in his study. Nobody's together. But you're all at home. Are you present in that case? No. So it's not just about being there. You have to actually say, okay, you know what? Let's be together. There's this thing we do now. You know, the house I went to the other day, and every child had their own gaming system. This PS4 thing. Every child had their own. Every child, so nobody shares. That's what they're saying. You cannot share. Every room has a TV. I don't do TV in bedroom, by the way. Put the TV. Let everybody, let them stay together. Let them commune. Let them be present in each other's lives as even siblings. And you'll be there for them and see what they're watching. And pay attention to them. So it's very, very important. And then communication. One way we must be present in our children's lives is that the way we communicate to them, verbally and non-verbally. Do you hug your child? Some children will say, Mommy, I love you. Oh no, we're not mommy. I think mommies have gotten over the way I love you. It's daddy sometimes. I love you. Thank you. Or what do you want? Learn to use endearment with your child. Learn to be vulnerable. Hug them. Give them those hugs. Give them those kisses. Touch them. Talk to them. Like I said earlier, ask them how their day was. Talk about your own day to encourage them. And when you're communicating, your responses are very important. You know, a friend told me how he told his mom how he liked this girl. He was 14. I like this girl. I really like her. And he told his mom who he felt he was really close to. And she went and told Baba. And Baba beat this guy. Already, girl. You want to get the girl pregnant? And that was the last time he ever talked to his mom about anything. And did he have girlfriends? Yes, he did. Yes, he did. He didn't share anything. And she lost a vital time to be able to educate him on so many important issues. How to treat women, how to wait the right time for sexual relations. She lost it. So communication is important with the way we do it. How do we do it? How do we react? How do we respond? Like I said, don't talk at them. Talk with them. Have conversations with them. My children, some parents might say, well, you can't be your child's friend. I disagree. There's a place for that parenting thing, but there's a place for the friendship. It's a different kind of friendship. It's not the friendship of you and your classmate, but it's a friendship, regardless. They should be able to open up and tell you, there's some things I will tell you about my child. My child, I know everything. I know their teachers. I know everything that's going on because they feel free to come and gist me, see what's going on, because I've learned to communicate with them and tell them about myself, so they feel very free with me. Now, somebody mentioned self-help. I think it was Halima. You cannot be present in a useful manner if you're not okay. Your presence will end up harming the other person. Because, you know, who knows, maybe that dude who was shouting was frustrated and having mental issues himself and just didn't know how to, he didn't know better. When you know better, you do better, for most people. So there was something my mom used to do when we were younger. She would come back from work. After we greet her, she would enter her room and lock the door for like 1 hour. And I couldn't understand it until I had children myself. And that her 1 hour in the room was, let me de-stress. I can't offer you guys anything right now. I'm tired, I'm irritable, they've annoyed me at work. I just need to. She'll have a bath, calm down. Then she will open the door. And mommy is ready to take on her 6 children. And she was a very present parent in every aspect of our lives. Every. She taught me how to. I grew up in Ikoyi, but I was always in Ajegunle and First Class and everywhere. She made me take the bus. She said, there's no driver today. Enter bus and learn. You will learn. You won't die. She was very present. She was so present that she understood who we are. Her and my dad were actually quite present. And the truth is that I stammer badly. Who noticed? Anyone who went to secondary school with me can't believe I can talk. Federal Benin, I could not talk. But because I had very present parents, my father would sit down with me after work. No joints, no hanging out with the boys. He would take a tape recorder and he would make me talk gently. Talk. Try it again. You're doing well, Chi. Do it again. Well done. And that's why I can stand in front of all of you like this today. So being present allows you to see the potential in your child, to know what they can do, to help them overcome their issues, their challenges, their inadequacies. Being present with your child helps you bring out the best in them. So I want to tell you, your child is meant to study. You say, no, I know her. She's an art student. She's meant to, I know her very well. It was because my parents were present. My mom knew that, look, you have to study law or something in the arts area because I was trying to study insurance. So she was like, girl, I know you. Because she was extremely, extremely present. And in being present, sometimes we have to make some choices. We have to give up some things because we want to be there for these children. It might be a choice of saying, okay, for instance, the other day someone said, oh, there's this training in Lagos. I love Lagos. I grew up in Lagos. So I'm always happy to go there. And I said, no, I'm already going to Port Harcourt and Kano this October. I'm not, I don't, it's okay. They'll pay me, but no, I'd much rather spend time with my children. Or there's some jobs you might get, like, this job is so great, so high profile. And you're like, the age my children are right now, I'm not sure. Okay, let me pray about it. Let me think about it. There's nothing wrong with thinking about things. You mustn't say yes immediately. You can take your time and think it through and be sure it's the right fit for you. Or even say, you know what, I'm taking time off work. I did that when I had my third child. I took time off work. I said, you know what, I just need to be here. I have 3 children. I'm not understanding myself. It's a bit too much. Let me just take a break. I took about a year or so to do stuff on my own, you know, until I was ready. And maybe you can't afford to take off time from work or whatever. That's where the agreement part comes in. Having a spouse who understands you and both of you working together to making sure even when one parent is not present, the other one is at every point in time. So that when trips have to be made, you can say, okay, you know what, honey, you go. I'll stay back with the children. Oh, you know what, I'll go. So there's so many things you can do. But the truth is that we have to ensure that being present is understood. It's not really about the gifts we give them. It's always said, presence over presence. Your presence is what's needed. Your presence must be enjoyable. Your presence must be something they look forward to. Yes, the goodies are part of it. We love them. It could just be granuts, nothing major. They will enjoy that granut more if you're there eating it with them. Now you bring in lots of stuff and you're never, ever, ever around. What are those important dates in your children's lives? Birthdays, recitals, things that are just really, really major. So you can tell your boss, okay, you know me, I'm always doing my work, but please, this one, please. Or have someone cover with you. That's why it's important to have a good connection with your colleagues at work so that they can cover up for you when you need to run to that school to watch your child give that thing they've been, you know, rehearsing for weeks on the stage. It takes a lot of intentionality, but I promise you it's so, so worth it. And let me end this by giving you my experience when I was doing my second master's in the UK, with my 2 younger children, 18 months and 7 years at the time. And it was just me and them. And I left my 2 older children at home with their dad. And it wasn't easy. I was, I committed to doing FaceTime and all of that every day. And my second son was to graduate from primary school. And he said, Mommy, please, I would really like you to be at my graduation. when are you done with school? And to be honest, I was going to be done about July, August. And the graduation was like early July. And I said, okay, I'll be there. And it meant me working really hard. It meant me doing so much. But I'm so happy that I made it. And I took those pictures with him and I was there for him. I had missed his whole year six, basically, because I was away. But just phone calls and just one visit. And I was there and I still made a distinction in the end because my heart was in it. So you can do it. You have no excuses, that's the honest truth. We have so much at our disposal. We have conferences like this, which our parents did not have, to help us plan our lives and say, you know what, I can be the best I can be as a parent. I can be there for them. Even with this whole busyness in this world, I can take time away and retreat and say, look, this is just time for me and family. I can do family holidays. I know better now, so therefore, I will do better. Thank you very much.